So I did this video talking about gel polish allergic reactions, or allergic reactions to a gel polish, which are lately, unfortunately, very, very common. And I keep talking about it because people keep asking me about these things. So today I got a really good comment, and I wanted to kind of break it down because there's a few very interesting things that this person mentioned. By the way, if you are new to this channel, thank you so much for clicking on this video. I am a nail technician of over 25 years, and initially I specialized in enhancement. So I did acrylics, gels, all of that stuff, fiberglass, whatever, gel polish. And now I pretty much specialize in natural nail care. I just love natural nails, and this is what I do. So I also have this YouTube channel where I help people I try to teach them how to achieve very, very beautiful natural nails, because it's possible. Okay, so let's talk about the allergic reactions, because so many people are using these products because they think, okay, this is great, a nail polish that lasts 2 weeks, but this is too good to be true, unfortunately. So this person says, I had this happen to me, so allergic reactions. Before the pandemic, I did a course on how to do gel polish on yourself, and I thought I knew most things. I needed to start doing it on myself, so I started doing it. And this is a very, very common thing. Every single person that writes to me about the allergic reactions, they don't know the allergic reaction even can happen. They don't know exactly how to avoid it. So when those courses are offered, or they tell you how to use the product, they kind of tell you how to really use it, but they don't teach you the chemistry behind these products and what can happen when these products are not used correctly. So if you don't know what can go wrong, then you don't know how to avoid it, right? During the pandemic, I started doing my nails more regularly, and I developed this type of allergic reaction. So really what it is, it's overexposure. So once the product is cured properly, which is actually extremely difficult to achieve, the products, all the acrylates, this is all acrylate family, these products are highly, highly allergenic. So over time, for some people, it happens very quickly, and for some people, it happens not so quickly, thankfully. People become overexposed to these chemicals. So basically your body says, I've had enough, and your body starts to react to it when you are exposed to those ingredients. She says, thankfully I went to a dermatologist and she prescribed a cream, and I stopped using gel polish. So the cream she probably prescribed, maybe there was two creams, so probably some kind of antibiotic cream if you had like really sores around your nails, and maybe she prescribed like a cortisone or something to bring down the inflammation, but that didn't treat the allergic reaction. It just treated the symptom. It's like a band-aid. Okay, I tried doing my own nails again after 2 years, and the allergy appeared again. So the allergy didn't really appear again, because once you are allergic, for life to these products, unfortunately. It's the symptoms appeared again because you have exposed yourself to these products again, and usually it becomes worse and worse and worse. Sometimes it becomes better when you expose yourself to a different ingredient, but that is very similar, but eventually your body goes, hold on a second, I think I remember this, and then it reacts big time, right? So I even went to a salon that used different products and got the allergy again. So what happens is, unfortunately, like I mentioned, you start developing this reaction to even a very similar product. So think about it this way. A friend of mine who's a content creator, polish lab rat, Larissa, she actually said it. She made a very good comparison. So she says, you know, if you are allergic to shrimp, it doesn't matter where you eat the shrimp. If you eat it in a restaurant or another restaurant, or if you make it yourself, you are going to be allergic to it. So it's not a good idea to ever eat it again. It doesn't matter, it's Christmas and you want to have a shrimp, it's just you are going to be allergic to it. So trying it again and again and again, and like, I don't know, shrimp in a pasta or shrimp in something else, it doesn't make a difference because there's still a shrimp in it. And then she says, I obviously stopped using them, but then I tried doing my friend's nails with two or even three gloves on, and I still got the allergy again. All along you had the allergy, it's just that you got the symptoms. Unfortunately, many people don't understand that gloves do not give you a lot of protection from acrylates. They're not made to protect you from acrylates. You would have to use, I think, maybe like a special, very, very thick gloves that mechanics are using. But once you are sensitized to these products, you can't even touch these products with gloves on, because these products, the acrylates, they go through the gloves. And unfortunately, especially if your hands are sweaty, it makes that even worse, because then your skin is compromised and the chemicals still make skin contact, okay? So the acrylates make a skin contact through the gloves. Guys, this is serious, okay? Let me say something important at the end of this message. She says, I finally got rid of the product and I will never use gel polish again. So this is not even gel polish. Any enhancements now you are overexposed to. So acrylic, probably fiberglass, you can't use any poly gel, anything. All of these products are the acrylate family. So you will react to all of it. Kind of sad because I loved it, but I'm thankful I caught it early and I didn't get any permanent scars or problems. And now this is a very important part and very sad part. That, of course, this is sad that now you can't have, you know, these, you can't use these beautiful products on your nails. But the scary part is that acrylates are used in dentistry, and they're also used for bonding bones. So for surgeries, like I think knee replacements or hip surgeries and things like that, acrylates are used, and dentists use acrylates. So if you are overexposed to any of these products, you have to make sure that you tell your dentist, because sometimes you won't be able to use certain, I don't know, fillings, or you might have problems with crowns and things like that. So you have to make sure that you tell dentists. So this is serious. This is not just like, oh, now I can't use gel polish, you know, so sad. It's just that now you have issues when it comes to the, you know, going to the dentist and even having surgeries. If you enjoyed this video, if you enjoyed this type of videos, these quick videos, please hit a like. This is really helpful. And also send the video to someone who is doing their own nails, because you know what? Sometimes you can help this person to possibly avoid lifelong allergic reactions. And if you would like to find out a little bit more about the overexposure to gel polish ingredients, how they happen, and if possibly HEMA-free or HEMA-free products are a better solution, then check out the post that I made on Patreon. There are some images that are a little bit, you know, concerning. So if you are very sensitive, just maybe don't look at the pictures, but you know, we have to know what's going on. So check out the article. The link is in the description box. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.